Hi, I'm Susanna, and I'm a product owner here at Pestler. And today I'm going to show you how to use our Microsoft Azure subscription cost sensor. Okay, so in order to add the Azure subscription cost sensor, the first thing you need to do is create a device. So we add a device and we give our device a name. In this case, we can name it Azure subscription cost. Okay, we leave the rest of the settings as they are. I will set localhost as my DNS name. And then the next thing you need to do is scroll down until you find the credential group called Credentials for Microsoft Azure. So once you enable that, you see you need four pieces of information in order to configure PRTG to work with Azure. And to get this information, you need to get it from the Azure portal. And we need to do some configurations there. So let's take a look. So I go into my Azure portal, and the first thing I need to do is create an app registration. So I go into app registration and click on new registration. I give my registration a name. In this case, PRTG Azure Sensors. I will leave the rest of the settings as they are. And in the end, you need to give them to give a redirect URI. You can either give your own if you have one. If not, you can use this one. So HTTPS login.windows.net. And then click register. All right, so now we created an app registration. And in the overview page, you can see we already have the application, our client ID, and the directory or tenant ID. So you can take this and immediately copy them to PRTG. So I will start with that. And the next thing we need is a client secret. Again, we need to go to the Azure portal. And to get a client secret, you go to the tab Certificates and Secrets. There, we click on New Client Secret. And we need to give our client secret a name. I will name it PRTG Azure Sensors Secret. And then you need to set an expiry date. I'll just leave it at 6 months. So you click on Add. And you see here we have created the secret. And here you can see the token or the value of the secret. But make sure that you copy it immediately. Because if you don't, then and you navigate outside of this page, then you will lose this value forever and it won't be visible. So either copy it immediately to PRTG or in some local file. I will just copy it immediately. And the last thing we need is a subscription ID. So to get that, we need to do a few more configurations. So we go to Home, and we navigate to a Subscriptions. There you need to choose a subscription for which you need to monitor. And then we go to Access Control. So the first thing we need to do at this point is to create a custom role. So I click on Add and Add Custom Role. And there we see we need to fill out some information. So there's two things you can do here. Either fill it out manually, or otherwise, I have a better suggestion. So you can go to our online knowledge base article called How Do I Obtain Credentials and Create Custom Roles for Microsoft Azure Sensors? And there, all you need to do is scroll down to the bottom, where you will find some JSON structures. And what you can do is copy the content into a local file in your local directory, and then upload it into Microsoft Azure. And that's exactly what I will do. I have already created the JSON file in my local directory. So I will click on Start from JSON, then select the file, and select the file I have created. And as you can see, all the information has been done automatically or filled in automatically. The only thing you need to do is go to assignable scopes. And here you can see there's an action missing because of this red dot. So I go to assignable scopes, and here you just need to assign the scope for which this is the subscription. This custom role is valid. So I will select the subscription that I have just entered, click on add, and then the last step is to review and create. And of course, you review them, and when everything is correct, you click on create. Okay, so now we have successfully created a custom role. So what you need to do next is assign this custom role to the app registration you created a few minutes ago. And to do that, we click on add, add role assignment. For role, you need to select the role you just created. So in our case, PRTG, Microsoft Azure Subscription Cost Center. You leave the assign access to as it is, and then in select, you need to select the app registration you just created. So in our case, it was PRTG Azure Sensors. And then you click on save. When that has been successful, all you need to do is go to Overview and get the subscription ID. You then go to PRTG and add the subscription ID. And that's all the configuration you need in order to make the Azure Subscription Cost Center work in PRTG. So you now click on OK, and your device is ready. So the last thing you do is add the sensor. So, subscription cost. Okay, so here we see there are some settings that you can already define before adding the sensor. And the first two, so the budgets, here you can see information about your budgets inside the sensor. If you click on disable, then obviously you won't see the information. But if you want to see the information in the form of channels, then all you need to do is click on enabled. The same goes for cost forecast. I will also enable this. The most expensive service allows you to see information about which service is the most expensive one in your sensor. If you want to get this information, you need to click on enabled. And there you can select the category by which it will display the most expensive service. So you could go by resource group or by resource type. I would just leave it in the default option. And I will create the sensor. All right, so here we can see the sensor and how the sensor works. We can see the budget information, and we can see the forecast information. If you hadn't enabled that setting in the beginning, then you would only get two channels, so the current period cost and the previous period cost. But now you see we also get information about our budgets and our forecast. And here on the top in the sensor message, you can see the information about the most expensive service. So the most expensive service is an SQL instance, and also the cost. So let's take a look in our sensor settings. Here we see that you can change the category by which it shows the most expensive service. So for example, we can choose resource type, but the budgets and cost forecast cannot be changed. So if you don't enable it in the beginning, then you would need to add the sensor anew if you want to see this information. So if I click on save, after a few minutes, you can see that the most expensive service has changed according to the category that we have selected in the settings. So that's how you configure a PRTG to work with Azure Subscription Cost Center. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If so, please like and subscribe. If you have any new topics or new things you would like us to do a tutorial about, please feel free to put it in the comments. If you need help with PRTG, you can contact our support at our website. Have a nice day, and thanks for watching.